In today's tutorial, I'll teach you how to convert your YOLOv8 model or YOLOv8 pre-trained model to OpenVINO format. So the question here now is, why should I convert my YOLOv8 model or a pre-trained model I have into OpenVINO format? That's the right question, honestly, but there are some numerous advantages of converting your pre-trained model to OpenVINO format you don't want to miss. The first advantage I will talk about here is higher inference speed. So we all know YOLOv8 models have extremely higher inference speed already, but the fact is converting them to OpenVINO format takes you one step ahead. It makes these models extremely fast and running inference become very fast. In addition to that, OpenVINO helps you to do model compression. Thus, it helps you to apply quantization, which helps you to reduce your requirements you need to run this model. Another advantage that I love the most is the cross-platform compatibility. So when you convert your model to OpenVINO, OpenVINO supports various platforms such as Windows, Mac OS, Linux, and so on. So you have this advantage of running your model on any operating system at all. OpenVINO also have a large community support, so in case something goes wrong, you know who to talk to, you know where to get some help. Apart from all these benefits, one more benefit I'll add to it is easy deployment. Deploying your model becomes easy because it supports many platforms. So we are going to start from scratch, where we take a pre-trained model or our custom model and convert this model from YOLOv8 format to OpenVINO format. So on my desktop, I'll create a new folder and I'll name this folder OpenVINO. Okay, so for testing purpose, I have this image right here, image of a cat. So we have four cats in this image. And I'll just drag and drop this image into our folder. And I'll open Visual Studio Code with this folder. Okay, so right here, we have the image of the cat. We drag in and you can see the folder name is OpenVINO. We are going to create a new file and we call this file main.py. So I can go ahead and close this. And the first thing I'll do right here is to create a new virtual environment. Okay, so the virtual environment is done. Next thing we'll do is to activate this virtual environment. And that's it. So in order to perform these tasks, we need to install some dependencies. And I think it's only one dependency we need. That's the OpenVINO library. So I'll just right click install OpenVINO. All right, guys. So the installation is done. I'll go ahead and close the terminal. And then from OpenVINO, I'm going to import YOLO. Okay. So the model we'll be using today is a pre-trained model. We are going to be using a pre-trained model from OpenVINO. But when you follow the same step with your own custom model, it's going to work. So I'll say our model is equal to YOLO. And inside the parentheses here, you have to type the model you want to use. So OpenVINO have many pre-trained models. Today, we are going to use a small version of their models. So you just have to type it right there. For that, I'm going to type YOLOv8x.pt. So this is for their smallest model. You can use the nano one as well by just replacing the S there with N. You can use the medium and you can also use the large by just writing L there, but we are going to use a smaller one. So when I run this code, it will go ahead and download this particular pre-trained model in my working directory. So let's give it a try by running this code. You can see the downloading I've started and it's downloading this pre-trained model right in my working directory. And you can see it right here. So you can see we have the smaller version of the YOLOv8 pre-trained model. Before we convert this model to the OpenVINO format, the first thing I would like us to do is to test this model on the image. So I have four cats in a single image and I'll just send this into the model for some prediction. This to validate that the model is working or not. And in here, I'll just type the name of the image, which is the cats.jpg. That's it. So I'll give it a run. Okay, so guys, here's the result right here. You can see 4 cats has been detected and it has taken 129.8 milliseconds to perform these tasks. So the thing is, after converting this model to OpenVINO, we are expecting that we have a higher inference speed. So we are expecting a lesser number than this. You can see it has used 2 milliseconds for pre-processing, it has used 129.8 milliseconds for inference and 3 milliseconds for post-processing per image of this particular shape. Okay, so the next step is to convert the model to OpenVINO format. I'll comment the testing code right here. And to convert this model is very easy. So we'll call this model VINO model, and this is equal to our model.export. And right here, you just have to specify your format you want this model to be converted in. So you can say our format is equal to not JPEG. Our format is equal to OpenVINO. So that's all you need to do to convert this model to OpenVINO format. So if I run this code, this will go ahead and convert our model. So let's run this and let's see how the conversion is done. So first, it will convert this model to a PyTorch format, then further convert this to ONNS format before it converts it finally to our OpenVINO format. So you can see we have ONNS here. Then it will further go ahead and export it from ONS to our OpenVINO format. So this will take some time. The conversion takes some time, but it's just some few minutes. Let's see, some couple of minutes, I'll say. So finally, our model has been exported to OpenVINO format, and you can get a saved model here. So it is saved to this directory, which is our working directory. So right here in the working directory, you can see we have the OpenVINO model. So the name is YOLOv8S OpenVINO model. When I open it, so normally OpenVINO model comes with two files. So we have the .bin file and the .xml file. So that's the format for OpenVINO models. We have it right here. So we just have to specify the path to this particular name and we can load in our model. So now that we have exported this model, no need for this line of code. We can comment it. We can now go ahead and load this model. So I'll still call this my VINO model. Is equal to YOLO, and right here we just have to type the name there. You can see the name right here, YOLOv8S OpenVINO model. So I'm just going to type this right now. All right, so this is the model, and we can go ahead and run inference on this model and also see how it performs. So I'll call this VINO result is equal to our VINO model. And in here, we can give it our image. So we call this image cats.jpg, which I'll copy right from here. So I'll comment this so that we can compare the speed. Or first, let's just run the OpenVINO one and see how it performs on the image. Okay, guys, so here is it. So it has used 100.9 milliseconds for running this inference. And you can see the speed it has used for pre-processing. It has used 100.9 milliseconds for inference and 2.8 milliseconds for post-processing. So now we can go ahead and compare these two models by running inference using the original YOLOv8 pre-trained model and the OpenVINO model so that we can conclude which one runs faster. For that, I will uncomment this right here. So first, we'll get a result for the pre-trained model, and then in the second part we'll get a result for the OpenVINO model. So you can see the difference right here, guys. So you can see the YOLOv8 model have detected 4 cats, which is true, and it has used 126.2 milliseconds in doing that. whilst the OpenVINO model, in the other hand, used 115.0 milliseconds. So you can see the difference in speed. You can see the OpenVINO format, or the OpenVINO model format, is very fast, and it's faster than that of the YOLOv8 model. So converting your model to OpenVINO offers numerous advantage for you, gives you higher inference speed, and then makes everything faster. And right here too, you can see it has maintained the accuracy. It has also detected 4 cuts by using a lesser time. So this is how easy it is to convert your model from YOLOv8 format, any model at all. This can be your custom model. It doesn't necessarily mean it should be a pre-trained model from Ultralytics. You can train your custom model and then convert this model using the same step. All you need to do is to use the name of your model right here, and then you convert this model to OpenVINO format. We are done. Then you can use the OpenVINO format for your daily tasks. So that's how it works. You can see clearly the speed it offers is faster than that of the raw model from Ultralytics. That's all for today. If you love this tutorial, make sure you give me a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and also share my content so that we build a learning community together. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you right in the next tutorial.